Hey, I made you a thing again, and there it is. Yes, it's completely free. Yes, completely customizable. Therefore, yes, you can change the color. In fact, I'm gonna add a color adjustment layer right now. Hue and saturation, and I'm gonna put it all the way on top. Okay, cool. Now you can just play with the hue, pick whatever color you want, right? I straight up deleted the background layer so that you can export it with a transparent background every single time. And as you can see, you have the design and there's two pieces of text. One is here, rules right there. I'm actually gonna color it to make it even more visible, make it red here. And then there's this thing that says icon. Icon is basically a group, and this is where you need to drag and drop whatever it is you want to put in here, basically. I'm also gonna put that in red. And within that group, currently, there is also just text. So let's say you want this to say about. In this case, you will just double click on the T and then type what you have to type. Double click on that R and just put in A. And just like that, you have your about section. That specific icon group has a bunch of effects that will basically modify whatever you drop in there. Let's say that you want a social media icon, for example. From my computer, I downloaded one from like Google Images. I can just drag and drop. And right now, since I had the group selected, it's gonna put it inside the group and automatically it's gonna be gray and it's going to have the drop shadow. And what I can do now is make sure I select the icon, Ctrl+Alt+T to transform, bring it down like that and then place it. You can see that it even has the little gradient top left here. Let's place it wherever I want, press enter. And then turn off the previous one. There you go. If you want different colors for different panels, for example, just double click on the layer icon here for the hue and saturation. And now we can go find something that looks kind of like Twitter, which is close to the original, to be fair. You can just move this. There we go. And to modify the text, again, I would put at name, right? Now, for example, this is like too big. I can select my text and I can go under the character options. If you don't see it, you can go to window mode and then click character. And I'm gonna just lower the size. That simple. And then with the move tool selected, I can just move it up a little bit. And there it is. When you're done, all you have to do is click file, export as PNG, click save, and then save it wherever you want. There you go. It will download it automatically. Just click on it and it will open up right there. As you can see, pretty high quality. It's even overkill if you plan on using it for Twitch or stuff like that. And yeah, you will see there's another folder called background, and it's basically what I did to create the background and every little spot, every little thing. If you're just curious as to like maybe the process of creating something like this, that will give you like a pretty decent insight. You don't have to touch it since you can just change the color. But yeah, if you're just curious, you wanna learn or just reverse engineer, or maybe there are some parts that you want to delete and stuff like that, it's all there. So one thing that's important is that I'm calling this a Twitch panel because I realize it applies as a Twitch panel really well. Originally, it was supposed to be like a Discord banner or a social media pop-up, which it can also be. So technically, you can use this to create a social media pop-up. Watch my previous tutorials if you don't know how to do that. You can use this as a Discord rule banner, right? If you don't know what a rule banner is, it's basically this that you can put on your rule channel just to make your embedded post look a little bit better, right? I will probably make a video tutorial just on this at some point. And of course, the most important part, how do you find this? And the way you access it is by going to photopea.com, and then from here, you're gonna see templates, okay? Now it's gonna appear here immediately, but if you don't see it, you can just type my name in the search bar and you'll see all of the stuff that I put here available completely free that you can also customize and export and use. But let's click on this. You're gonna click here and then you're gonna click on the image or the link or whatever, and you're gonna have access to it. Once again, in order to customize it, you can double click on the T, that's the layers icon, and then you can type whatever you want. Right? And then there's an icon folder where you can drag and drop whatever icon that you found on Google Image. If you want to put your SoundCloud or your MySpace, go find their logo, drop it inside that folder, and it will look gray like that. And you can just place it. Ctrl+Alt+T to transform, to scale it down and stuff. Or you can just use that thing that we have here, that text that we have here. Double click on the T and just put the first letter. And export, file, export as PNG. Very simple. Anyways, that's it for me. Thank you so much for watching. Go out there, make me proud, get level out.